Hi all, in this video we are going to learn how to create a simple Excel macros function. I request everyone to watch this video from starting to end completely. I have given a step-by-step procedure on how to perform a basic macro which helps us to complete our task easily. So without any delay, let's get into our session. Welcome to Aztec Vlogs and my name is Santosh. Let's understand a brief about macros first. I'm not getting into too technical explaining what is macros. To make audience understand in a layman language, macros is nothing but a recorded function of process which you perform step by step to complete our task in Excel. Once we're done with recording our process by following system command, we need to save the recording. Later, instead of we performing the same task in Excel manually, just by running macros, system will take care of things in automated way. Here I have taken a sample data which talks about loan status of customer. We have huge set of data, but for this training session we are going to look three combinations: loan status, home ownership and term, which is marked in gray color. Here is the scenario. Every hour there is a report getting generated regarding loan status and call center executive need to call those customers who falls in the particular category. Instead of doing manual work, how are we going to segregate those data to a different sheet for an easy access to proceed further by customer care executive? I have given four separate tabs in Excel, so while running macros, based on the condition given, the data should automatically get captured in the blank sheet for easy access and to avoid manual work. To create a macros, there should be an option in our ribbon called Developer. Here I have already selected and kept. For those who are not getting this option, please don't worry, just follow the steps what I am saying now. Just click on the file. Under file, you can see an option called options. Click on that options. You can see an option called customized ribbon. Click on that customized ribbon. Under customized ribbon, you will be seeing an option called main tab. Select that main tab. Under main tab, we can see the option called developer. Just give OK. Now you can see this option got enabled in your Excel. Let's do a practical session on macros function and see how it works. Select option called record macro under developer tab. Now you can see option called macro name, shortcut key, store macro in and description. Give a good name under macros name. For an example, I am giving loan calls. Next option is shortcut key. You can see that shortcut key looks with a combination of control plus. Please keep in mind, if you give any pre-built combination as shortcut key which already exists in system, it will start performing macro input rather than its actual input. For an example, if you give control plus B, actual work of the shortcut key is to bold the selected text in section. If we give the same here, it will start taking macro input rather than its actual purpose. My suggestion is we can neglect this option. However, I am going to give you a better idea on how to run the macros without shortcut. Performing macros in this particular sheet, hence selecting the same, and description we can leave it as blank. Now click OK. Our macros started getting recorded. Now we need to give direction to macros what work it needs to do. As I said earlier, we are going to give this condition and try to run macros. Click on the raw demo which I have already mentioned as week 1. These have combination of multiple datas. I have highlighted few columns in gray color, which is nothing but our conditions that we are going to work. Our first condition is, under fully paid, we need to select rent and tenure 36. I am selecting those particular details and giving instruction to macro, just copy paste those details, copy those details and paste it under fully paid tab. I am just copying it and I want the same macro need to do and paste it under fully paid tab. This is the instruction which I given to macros now. Our second condition is, under delinquent loan status, home ownership own, tenure, we need to select those details and the same process we are going to follow. We are going to select delinquent, under delinquent home ownership we need to select own. Yes, we are selecting own. Under own we are going to select term as 60. This is another instruction I am giving to macros. Copy this particular data and paste it under delinquent tab. Yes, this is the instruction which I given to macros, copy and paste. Like the same I have did for current and default tab also. Now we have given set of instruction to macros on what workflow and condition that needs to work under all four tabs. Now it's time to cross check whether the given information is going to work out or not. Before that, we need to stop this particular recording. Go to developer tab and select stop recording. By this we will complete the entire process and the condition which we have already given. So far we have seen how to segregate the different combination of data to respective tab. We will also see how to delete those data in case of we going to add new set of information. We are going to follow the same process how we did for adding the details. Now we are going to give for deleting. Give some macro name, click OK, and we will follow the same process. Here the condition is very simple. We going to delete data from all those four tabs. So directly go to those page and select those details and click delete, so that the entire details will get deleted from those tabs. So from each, on each tab I am going to perform this function. Under fully paid, delinquent, current and default. Post this, the same method what we did in recording adding data, the same we going to do it for deleting data also. Go to home page and click on developer stop recording. By that we will completed a process of adding data as well as deleting a data. As I said earlier, instead of giving shortcut key, I have a better option to assign and rent the macros, whatever we recorded still now. For that, we need to select the option insert, and from there, we need to pick the first button symbol from form controls. Once you draw that switch, it automatically take you to the command as shown in the screen. Now we need to assign what this button going to do. This button I am going to use to pull data as per the combination given. Hence I am assigning this button to loan calls macro. Post assigning, you can give a name to that button, where here I have given pull data and give escape. Yes, we have given the name just escape. Now I am going to do the same delete option also. Select the same button and assign delete macro and give a name to that button. We can draw the same symbol and we need to give some name to it. like how I'm doing it in screen right now. Yes, just ascend a little, give OK, and give some name. Correct. Now our macro file is ready. Let's see how it's get function. I've already deleted data from the sheet. If you can see, I've already deleted those data. Now if I click on pull data switch, all the details should get in place in the respective tab. Let's see. I'm clicking on that switch. Macros is running. Now we need to see all those tabs got filled with the data. Yes, see, it's working perfect. Whatever conditions that we are given, that got added over here in all the tabs. Perfect. So the recording whatever did is correct, and we got the result also. Like the same, we will do it for delete function. Let's see whether the data is getting deleted or not. Yeah, I've given delete option. Let's see on all the tabs whether the data got deleted. Yes, all the data got deleted. By this, we are ending up our session here. With this basic concept, we can create multiple macro files, which helps you to do work automatically and reduce your workload by 75%. Hope you all got a chance to learn something from this session. Only support we require from you is, please subscribe and share our channel. Also help us by giving your valuable feedbacks in comment box, which helps us to improve our future content in a better way. Thank you, and bye now from Hashtag Blogs.